Kepler's first law of motion states that planets orbit on ellipses with the sun located at one focus. Newton generalized that to any two bodies to say that two bodies orbit on ellipses with their common center of mass at one focus. Center of mass is a familiar concept to all of us if you've ever used a beam balance. We're going to demonstrate it using a meter stick. I've got a 1 meter stick here. I've got a hanger, which I set at the 50 centimeter mark, and I hold it up with a couple of weights on the end, and it will be in almost perfect balance. I am at the center of mass, both of those two clips, and there is a little bit of self-weight on the stick. If I move to a place away from that center and try to hold it up, the results are quite predictable. The system is out of balance. If I then put on two unequal weights, I need a couple of unequal weights. I have a small warthog, and I have a somewhat larger mama warthog. And I'll put them onto clips at both ends of the meter stick. Mother warthog, I know from measuring, is 4 times the mass of baby warthog. I put the balance point at the dead geometric center between them, and what happens if I let go? Exactly as predicted, the heavier warthog is going to pull the balance beam down. The center of mass is such that the ratio of the distances of the two masses from the balance point is equal to the inverse of the ratio of their masses. That tells you the balance point should be closer to the heavier one than to the lighter one in proportion to the ratio of their masses. Since these are in a ratio of 4 to 1, I expect them to be at approximately the 4 to 1 position. Let's do that. And sure enough, they're roughly in balance. Now, those of you who are paying attention will notice that I've cheated a little tiny bit. This is not exactly the 4 to 1 position, and the reason is because I've taken into account the self-weight of the stick. In a planetary system, this would not be taken into account. It would just be the two masses because there's no stick between them, just space. If I now set these into orbital motion, the orbital motion will be about their center of mass. And I can do that by spinning the warthogs around their balance point here. You'll notice that the bigger mass, the mother warthog, is orbiting closer to the center of mass, whereas the baby warthog, the smaller mass, is orbiting further away. This is not an accident. This is what the consequence of Newton's version of Kepler's first law says. Both bodies are in motion, but the heavier body is closer to the center of mass than the more distant body. But notice, while they are more distant, they have the same period. They both go around at exactly the same rate as they move around that center position.